obviously.
Yeah, yeah.
Yesterday, the Uganda National Roads Authority forcefully closed down the Kabale-Chisoro Road at Hamura Town Council to pave way for the repairs on the road that was devastated by mudslides on Thursday. Uganda National Roads Authority later released a statement advising motorists to use the Kabale-Katuna-Rubaya-Moko Road, 88 kilometers, to access Chisoro. Travelers were advised to use the Kabale, Lake Bunyonyi, Katwenkano, Kagarama, Haisensero route 20 kilometers on their way to Chisoro.
But what brings me here is to come on behalf of the central government to thank these engineers for ensuring that connectivity to the rest of the country and indeed to DR Congo and is restored immediately.
However, the State Minister for Works and Transport, Musa Itweru, says closing such a vital road has tough effects on the country's economy and the neighboring countries of Rwanda and Democratic Republic of Congo.
The assumption was that this is a consequence of shoddy work. But we consulted these engineers. The truth is that this road was done very well. The reality is also that for some time, immediately the roads were done, like this one, we should have immediately embarked on the periodic maintenance.
According to Itweru, the Works Ministry has already designated 3 billion shillings to help Uganda National Roads Authority repair the roads that were badly hit by the recent landscapes in Kigezi sub-region.
I have directed the engineers of the districts, this district of Kigezi, to prepare small budgets which will help them at least fuel their equipment so that they can also do community access roads which are blocked. I hope to get the one of Rubanda now before I go back, and also the one of Kisoro has already, I think, been sent to Kampala.
He adds that they will also consider empowering the local authorities to upgrade the status of accessing roads to secure alternative routes in case similar disasters hit again.
The district engineers are going to submit their bills of quantities modest for working on those roads that pass through the rural setting but are critical for diversion here.
From there, the minister also visited the Hamura floating bridge that connects Hamura to Kanungu district. The place was submerged by the floods, but Itweru says this spot will be upgraded as the country prioritizes tourism roads in the next financial year.
But we are going to bring in new projects like this one, this what we call the tourism roads. Those ones are going to be priority for opening up, for upgrading the road now from what you see to tarmac. The tourism roads, particularly in Kigezi, have been emphasized. Kigezi and the Rwenzori region, and a little bit of Kidepo in Karamoja.
The Rwanda district chairperson, Stephen Kasabia, said that the Kabale-Chisoro road is not in a good shape because it was not properly drained during its construction.
The drainage system of this road is very poor. There is no drainage. The maintenance is not there. Because, I mean, where is the passage for water? The drainage system was not properly constructed. That's what, when they are working on maintaining this road, they must think about the drainage system of this road up to Kisoro.
Kigezi is among regions across the country that is receiving heavy rains. The heavy rains have so far caused the death of 18 people in the districts of Ruchiga, Rubanda and Chisoro between the night of Tuesday to Wednesday this week. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.